So I'm here with Vikramaditya Kulkarni, who is one of the finest players of Mumbai. Vikram, how was the game today in the first round of Mayor's Cup?
Slight irregular, you can say. I started with English and after the four nights came out, I played A3. So it was a kind of reverse Sicilian pelican-like situation in which in Pelican, what happens if knight goes to f5 instead of b5? That was the thing with reverse colors.
So can you tell us some of the moves like
for c4 the e5, nc3 nf6, nf3 nc6, a3 d5, cd5 nd5 e4. I think she I don't know whether knight f4 is good or bad. She played knight f4. Then as in Sveshniko it should be played, I played d4. Yeah, I think she should play e into d4. She played knight into d4. After e into d4, if I take the bishop into f4, then d into c3, she will get that ending. My pawn will on c3 will be isolated. So, I don't know what it is. I have an extra tempo with a3 move. But she played knight into d4. I thought she was hoping for the same endgame without the pair of knights also. But after knight into d4, knight into e5, I played. And then she has to play knight f6. And then I play bishop e3. Now the knight in on d4 is stuck for a while. And then she cannot play bd6 because bishop into d4 is coming. So she has to just develop bishop e7. At some point she has to play c5, but she first developed bishop e7. Then I was thinking about whether to play f4 or first develop pieces and all, but I thought f4 is good. So I played f4 and her pieces started to come in trouble. After f4, she played g6, she should have played c5, I think. At least the d4 knight would always have a support. Then g6, then I played queen f4 check, and she didn't want to become pawn down by bd, playing some variation was making a pawn down, bd7 or something. After queen f4 check, anyway, she had to play king f8. And then to my strong attack started. King f8, then I played bishop c4. Now the f7 x-ray attack on f7 is coming. Then she played, here she played c5. Then bishop into e6 came, bishop into e6, bishop into d4, she played bishop d6. Then bishop into e6, bishop into e6, bishop into d4, c into d4, queen into d4. Now the d6 bishop is hanging and I am also threatening knight into g6 check and h8 rook is going. The only move was king e7, then I played f5. Now with the e6 bishop moves, I have f6 check or knight d5, all sorts of threats are there. So she played f6, I think that was the best way. f5, f6, I took f into e6, she played f into e5, no. She played bishop into e5. F into e5 was little better. But then I would get queen f2 and then queen h4, queen f7, knight d5. One idea was queen h4 check, king into e6, queen h3 check, king e7, knight d5 check. So these were the winning ways. But she played bishop into e5, then I played queen b4 check. Now the rook is taking the queen and check is there. So bd6 is forced. Then queen into b7 check, king into e6. Now I thought that I should not let the king go on the 7th rank back. It should stay on e6. So I played e5, f into e5, rook h1, threatening queen f7. So she cannot move the queen because then it will get overloaded because it has to support d6 also. Always queen d5 will double attack the bishop. So she played rook f8, then she lost the piece. Queen d5 check, king e7, rook into f8, and the d6 is gone. After rook into f8, she resigned.
So it was a very nice and clinical first round victory for you. How does it feel to play in the hometown Mumbai?
First thing I have to think is whether I have to, the commute is going to be long or short. Before other things.
It is long for you, right?
Yeah. Quite. Of course, I never stay at home and play. But even wherever I am staying, even from there, it will be long or short. That is the first thing.
So it's not the most pleasant feeling to play in the hometown, yeah?
This issue is bad, the commute thing. But otherwise, I like to play in Bombay. I made my first IMNOM in Bombay Commonwealth in 2003. Tulip Star.
Can you tell us at what age you became an IM?
became. I am in 2007, so I was a little short of 25.
You were 25. Okay. And your highest rating has been somewhere around 2470, right?
2465 in 2011.
Wow. So you, and do you have any GM norms?
I said so happened that if I would win that particular round, I would get the norm, but I didn't win. I either lost or did. Once I was piece up, clean piece up against Kotsur in an ending, but I drew it.
So many times the norm has been missed.
Three times.
One question which I have been asked by many people, and whenever I talk about Mumbai chess, is about you. That with the amount of talent you had and the amount of the level of play you had, why weren't you able to fulfill that potential? Of course, you are trying hard even now, but why were you not able to reach the GM title in spite of being such at a good level?
I think I did not plan the things properly. Whenever I reached, I crossed 2400 in 2005, but after that I should have, at that stage I was not playing great, although I crossed. So I should have understood and I should have taken a gap and prepared a lot and played, but instead of that I played a lot and then I lost the rating. After a few years again I crossed 2400, I thought this time I should take a gap, but that also went wrong. It should have been 50-50 type of a thing. These things I did not strategize properly. I took spontaneous decisions, so maybe these things happened, and somewhere lacking in study also. Diligent study has not happened. Continuous diligent study for 6 months or 8 months. It has happened for 1 or 2 months and then I become a little loose about it. So diligence and not finding the best direction, either with guidance or by self-pondering.
You talk about guidance and strategizing. For youngsters, how would they be able to get that? Who should they go to for such help? Like, you should be playing tournaments now, or you should work very hard and prepare for a few months. Who would guide them?
I think one person should always be there. The first person who saw, the first coach who saw them grow, like from becoming rated to strong rated, he will always know what he does, what the player does, and what he has. What pluses he has, what minuses. Otherwise, it is difficult to understand which player, which person will understand you correctly and give you the right decision. Perhaps if your parents know a little bit of chess, father can guide. My father is a total non chess player, but at times he had given great advices which I ignored, and 6-7 years later I understood that they applied well in chess.
So now you take them seriously.
Yeah, I take them very seriously.
And now you are around 35 years old. Are you still trying for your GM title?
Yeah, totally trying. I mean, I have to divide time now. I do coaching and all. But a few years back, I was less serious about it. Now I am quite serious.
Viku, we wish you all the best. And you achieving your GM title will inspire a lot of people. So good luck for that.